Right before the playoffs started, Paul George is playing some of his best basketball in the bubble. He was averaging 25 points, 5 boards, and nearly 4 assists, shooting 48% from the field, 50% from 3, making 4 a game, and he shot 83% from the line. Once I seen this, I was like, oh yeah, this is going to be the year Paul George finally lives up to his nickname, Playoff P.
Yeah, I'm used to it. I'm used to this. Y'all ain't met Playoff P yet, huh? I'm used to these matchups. I'm used to playing against the best offensive guy.
After game one against the Mavs, I would say he did a pretty good job living up to that name. He had 27 points, shooting 45% from the field, 36% from 3, and he was perfect from the line.
He only hit 5 3-pointers all season, 5. Paul George hesitated, now gets inside, goes right at Porzingis.
But after game one, he went back to having really bad games in the playoffs. In game two, he had 14 points, shooting 23% from the field and 20% from 3. Then he posted this after the game, so I thought he was going to go off in game 3, but I was wrong. He only had 11 points, shooting 18% from the field and 12% from 3.
Kawhi, Paul George struggled again tonight shooting the basketball. I know you won the game, but can you win this series the way he's shooting?
Yeah, we can. We're confident, and you know what I mean? It's going to turn around for him, and I mean, we got his back.
I'm obviously struggling shooting, struggling scoring the ball, but I mean, it is what it is. It didn't affect us winning tonight, so you know, I'm gonna continue to just get lost in the game. Whether I make shots, I miss shots, I'm gonna continue to be aggressive.
Right now in the playoffs so far, he's averaging 17 points, 7 boards, and 4 assists, shooting 30% from the field and 24% from 3.
Here's Paul George, they're getting him the ball early. A little hesitation, gets himself free, no. Paul George will pull. Boy, that one missed badly.
Playoff P can't keep getting no passes. And listen, let me tell you something.
What kind of passes are you giving him?
No, because you can't be calling yourself Playoff P and lose all the time. You don't see me walking around saying, hey, I won the championship and I didn't win it.
They'll call you Championship Chuck.
They'll call me Championship Chuck.
Championship Chuck. I thought you guys gave him that name. And I found out this morning that he names himself that.
Are you allowed to give yourself a nickname, or does that have to come from someone else?
I thought it had to come from somebody else.
He should have never called himself Playoff P if he was going to perform like this. I like his confidence, but I don't even know why he called himself this if he's never really been consistent in the playoffs. For his career, he only has 20 games where he shot over 50% in the playoffs, and he has 41 games where he shot under 40% from the field. His best playoff series was in 2016 against the Raptors. He averaged 27 points, 7 boards, and 4 assists, shooting 45% from the field, 42% from 3, and 95% from the line. He needs to get back to this Playoff P right here.
This point.
But George took it back and scores the... George for 3, and a good start. George looking for the contact. Tomorrow on ABC, Stan Van Gundy, the coach of the Pistons, says...
I think Paul George is going to bounce back, though. There's no way he's going to continue to play like this. He's going to start hitting shots again soon, and when he does, this Clippers team is going to be a problem. But do y'all think the Mavericks can still win this series without Luka Doncic? Let me know in the comments. And if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe for more vids. Peace.